The Foreign Affairs Department is holding a press briefing in Malacañang. This is ANC Live.
Filipino citizens in Gaza. Our embassy in Amman updated these figures. There's less Filipino citizens in Gaza, 131 actually, 131. Some left already before this outbreak. So it's 131, including 3 tourists. So what I see. Out of the 131, up to 92 now are asking for repatriation. And that's as of several hours ago. By now, baka umakyat na. So 92. You say 92, that's over 70%. And not one has been repatriated yet because of the fact that Gaza is under a blockade. But we are working on it. We are working with our partners, diplomatic partners, no, to see if a humanitarian corridor can be opened to allow people to exit through, obviously, through not, if not the border with Israel, through the Rafah border with Egypt. As for Kababayans in Israel, there are already some who have indicated that they want to go home, not because they were victimized by the war specifically, but because indirectly, they lost their jobs or times are hard for them for economic reasons, therefore obviously aggravated by this conflict. So there are at least 22 Filipinos in Israel who have indicated that they want to go home. The first batch at government's expense will be leaving on October 8th. There are 8 of them. Expenses October 16. There are 8 of them leaving on October 16. Sorry. Leaving on October 16, paid for by the Department of Migrant Workers and OWA. And as they have promised, once they arrive, they'll be given the proper assistance, no, the usual reintegration and other assistance packages provided by the DMW and OWA. Now, there are reports that we have been repatriating those students who, you may have heard of 300 plus students, agricultural students, who are accounted for, and that we've been repatriating them. Not exactly. There was the first batch which already arrived. It's already arrived about 68, I believe, if the number is right. They're not at our expense because these were upon the conclusion of their studies and they are leaving. Right now, there are still flights out of Israel. El Al airline is still operating. Other airlines apparently have closed their flights, but there are flights. There are flights in and out of Israel, but may we repeat a travel advisory. And best not to approach, best not to go to Israel now at the current time. In fact, we had a Zoom meeting last night with our embassies in Tel Aviv and in Amman and in Cairo. And our embassies in Tel Aviv right now are preparing for, in case there's a need for evacuation, although it's not likely, of course, they're seeing about buses and all. And they were told by a rental company in the north that, no, we can't lend a bus because we are touring Filipino here. There are Filipino tourists in Nazareth or in Galilee. So, of course, now the embassy in Amman is assisting our tourists, Filipino tourists in Israel who cannot leave if, in case their flights were not via El Al, to leave via Jordan. In fact, 4 have entered Jordan from Israel for this tourist. So the situation in Israel is not a big problem if it refers to the evacuation of nationals, because the situation there is more stable, and we're ready to repatriate them, and we don't expect big numbers. It's our Kababayans in Gaza. Ganun po. So, obviously, Israel has indicated that they will undertake measures to eliminate Hamas. So, Gaza has been placed on voluntary repatriation or crisis alert level 3. Israel is still on alert level 2, which is non-deployment. And so is the West Bank, which is the right side of the second land portion of Palestine, or the state of Palestine.
Sir? So ano ba po yung latest ngayon, yung since this morning?
Yes, I regret to inform you, you are aware that as of yesterday, there were two confirmed Filipino fatalities. I think the media, in fact, it's already in the front page, knows the identities, but I will still not divulge the names because it's already known. All right, one man and one woman, it's known. And four missing, including one for confirmation. I regret to inform you that, yes, it is confirmed, there is a third Filipino casualty. A 49-year-old woman from Negros Occidental. Her family is aware, the president is aware. And the Philippine government, of course, is working. Yes, is working with a family. The embassy in Israel is in touch with the sisters who are in Kuwait, actually, for the repatriation of remains. So that leaves, according to the embassy, three casualties and three missing Filipinos still. However, it doesn't mean that there's no hope, because as we said before, there were a lot more missing a week ago, and then paunti ng paunti. So possibly these three will still show up, no? We hope. And now we join the nation in extending our deepest sympathies to the relatives of the latest casualty, who was also a caregiver. Yes, so, of course, we thank also the Israelis for their assistance for our kababayans, no, who need protection in Israel right now.
Okay. Eden Santos, Net25.
Yusek, since tatlo na po'y confirmed, kasama po yung 49-year-old woman from Negros Occidental, and still three missing, ano po. Meron kasing family po na napanood yung kanyang asawa sa video na hit. Kinukuha po, ano, no hostage. Lalaki po yun. Hindi, kasama po ba yun doon sa missing?
Opo. Yun pong hindi po siya isa sa mga tatlong casualties, nasa missing po.
So nasa missing po, until now wala pa po tayong information kung nasaan po.
Wala pa. May I now go on the president's instructions for us, because we met with the president yesterday. He said that the immediate concern is repatriation. But nobody right now can go get in or out of Gaza. So repatriation, of course, is not yet possible at this time, unless the humanitarian corridors are made open. So this is a diplomatic initiative. We are in touch with the governments in the region. Of course, the United Nations will hold a hearing, a session today, the United Nations Security Council, and we expect them to call for a humanitarian corridor to allow civilians to leave. But once it is declared, once the opening is declared, we must be ready, and in fact, we are getting ready. Our embassy in Cairo is sending a team to the border, and we are providing them funding to be able to rent the necessary transportation to bring them from the border to Cairo and to fly them to Philippines, Yutong 92. Kung, according to our embassy in Amman, which is in touch with them, the Filipinos in Gaza, and I myself know Gaza, I was stationed in Israel before, are very resilient. They will, if they are told, meet here, they will. Or if they're told, just show up at the border at this time, they will. Because it's only at most 30 minutes from Gaza City and other parts of Gaza to the Egypt border. So we will be ready. The president also directed the Department of Foreign Affairs to contact countries, and also through their embassies in Manila also, to provide critical assistance in looking for Filipinos who are unaccounted for, and to help the Filipinos, Philippines in getting them out of Gaza. At the same time, ASEAN countries have also approached us for help. At the same time, they offer help. For example, Indonesia is offering to help Filipinos who want to leave the West Bank. Well, they have no presence in Gaza, obviously, but they have citizens in Gaza, so they're asking our assistance. So it's a international approach. No? He also, the president also directed relevant agencies to prepare for, of course, the reintegration and of the Filipinos when they come home, which is standard every time you repatriate Filipinos. No? And of course, that includes the receipt of ayuda, or financial assistance. And now about the need for permits to enter. Of course, first it's needed for Israel to agree to a humanitarian corridor, and it's needed for Egypt to allow citizens to enter through their borders. So we are also talking with our friends from Egypt about that, so that our Kababayans who want to be repatriated could be brought there. In the president's words, what is critical now is Gaza, and let's keep exploring all possible exit options. You already know that he has met the Israeli ambassador, who has promised that no civilians are being targeted. Nevertheless, if Israel, as they say, actually conducts an operation against Hamas targets, there will be civilians who will naturally be casualties. We aim, hopefully, that no Filipino will be among the casualties. Let me give you a profile of the Filipinos in Gaza. So there's about 131 of them. Not all are Filipinos, Filipina women married to Palestinians. Some are their children, or even grandchildren. So they are practically of Arab ethnicity, you see? Now, the spouses of the Filipinos are Palestinians. We cannot guarantee what Israel or Egypt will decide. So it may be a difficult decision like what happened in Ukraine. If a Filipino woman will leave, she may need to leave her husband and go to the Philippines with her kids, but not with her husband. Same thing happened in Ukraine. Some remained, some left. So that's something, that's a reality, no? Our concern, of course, is the Kababayans. The embassy in Amman is also thinking about the Kababayans. There are 70 of them in the West Bank. But nobody is interested there. No, not one of the Filipinos there would be interested in leaving, because in part, well, they don't feel the conflict. They don't feel the violence from that area. So it's okay. It's all right. But there may be unrest, because there will be protests, you know, the usual rallies whenever, you know, there's skirmishes. So they'll just be avoided. Advised to take at most precautions po. So ganun po yun ang instructions ni President, work on the repatriation, talk with governments, make sure that those who return are given the proper ayuda. And time is of essence. Our embassy is already sending their team to the border.
Yung follow-up yung kanina na po. Clarification lang po, Yusek. Yung pong 22 Filipino in Israel, hindi po yun sa Gaza galing?
No, hindi po. Hindi po. Ito yung mga talagang OFW sa Israel na wala na ng trabaho, dahil sabi ng embassy, yung iba doon dahil hotel workers, tapos nagkasasaring hotel. Hindi lang dahil sa crisis, pero recently, dahil intense yung situation or what. So wala na siyang trabaho. So they've decided to just go home.
So yung 92 po, sa Gaza po yon.
Sa Gaza. Nagpa-parinig na, nagpa-iwatid na gusto nilang umuwi.
Umuwi po. As long as makakuha tayo ng humanitarian corridor.
The humanitarian corridor for them to exit through Egypt, no? And of course, Egypt has to give their permits, no? Kasi same as if you remember yung sa Sudan, ganun din, no? Pero dito po, yung galing Khartoum sa Sudan, ilang oras yun, maraming oras para makarating sa border ng Egypt. Tapos ang tagal nila naghihintay doon para papasukin sila ng Egypt. From the border, ilang oras naman by bus pumuntang Cairo. This will be less kasi mas maliit ang distansya dito, no? Ganun pa man, pinapaabot namin sa inyo, once they leave, there's no guarantee na pagdating sa border, baka hindi agad silang papasukin. They may also wait 1 day, 2 days, 3 days, tulad na nangyari sa Sudan. So, we're counting on the UN. And of course, there will not just be Filipinos. Huh? There will be other nationalities as well, no? Let us, of course, we have to anticipate the possibility that what will finally be decided is that only foreigners will be allowed out. But that's a lot of foreigners still, no? Not just Filipinos. So they'll be there. I'm sure the international community, the Red Cross and other organizations will find a way to provide them food and all that in case they have to stay at the border while their papers are being processed. However, inayos na ng ating embassy sa Cairo at Amman yung kanilang travel documents or kanilang passports or what. So they have the papers to be able to travel to the Philippines. The question is entry to Egypt, safe entry to Egypt. But we're working on that in full accordance with the instructions of the President.
Okay. Marcel Halili, TV5. Sir, yun pong nabanggit ninyo kanina, first batch po nung magre-repatriate sa Israel sa October 16. So kailan po yung inaasahan natin na the remaining...
We don't expect it to take long because they're only 20 days. It's just a matter of getting them commercial tickets, commercial flights. So I'm sure by the end of October, nakawin na mga yan. And then let's see if there will be more who will ask. Possibly, if there's a full-scale war already, possibly there'll be more who, for understandable reasons, might say, I better leave Israel. But it's not that complicated for Israel because we could just book them commercial flights or drive them to Jordan. Of course, they'll need clearance as well. And then from Jordan, fly them home. So, hindi po yun ang problema yung sa Gaza.
Okay. Sir, yun pong kanina na yung third Filipino po na na-confirm na casualty, may we know kung ano po yung naging cause nung death niya?
No, I myself don't have that information. Just the embassy said that the morgue and the Jerusalem police confirmed. Okay. Filipino. Apparently, the landlady also, I'm sorry, not the landlady, the employer, I think, tweeted it also, or messaged it. That unlike yung pangalawang namatay na Filipina, sabay yung amo, at saka siya namatay. No, that's the second one. This is the third one, unfortunately. So it's two women and one man.
Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN.
Sir, to confirm, yung third Filipino fatality, ito po yung kinoconfirm natin through yes. DNA testing.
Yes, or DNA or other testing, yes. Yes, apo. Yes.
Tapos, sir, may monitoring na po ba tayo? Just sa situation mismo ng mga Pilipino na nasa Gaza, considering na may blockade nga po doon, mahirap yung pagkain, yung tubig,
yes,
yung Korean.
Ayoko sabihin good news because it's not... Di ba sinabi na Israel is blocking, not allowing electricity, water, and so forth? Kasi they're the ones actually under the arrangements. Israel provides electricity, water, food. Kasi they, although they withdrew from the Gaza Strip in 2005, they still control, in effect, the borders. So they're the ones allowing things to go in or out. According to our embassy in Amman, they still have electricity, water, etc., but limited for a few hours a day. So our embassy is in touch with them. They're not dying of hunger, you know, there is. They are not yet, they're not casualties, of course. So they're in touch. So, ang susunod, of course, is to inform them when it's the right time, when it's possible. to go to the border. If need be, if possible, we will also provide them a transportation from the cities in Gaza. It's not large. No, at most it will take 30 minutes lang to the border. But ang sabi ng ating ambassador, Filipinos, and we know this, very resilient, very resourceful. Just tell them where to meet or where to go. They will arrive there. If the question though, as the president also said, papayag ba yung ating mga kababayan na hindi kasama yung kanilang mga asawa? Let's first hope that eventually we'll be able to have that humanitarian corridor. But we have to be ready. It could be any time in the next few days or week, maybe.
And another question.
DFA Undersecretary Eduardo De Vega there headlining that press briefing of the Department of Foreign Affairs there in Malacañang. And as he gave the current situation, what is happening in Israel and in the Gaza Strip, the confirmation as well that a third Filipino has died in the conflict between Israel and Hamas. The Filipino, a 49-year-old caregiver who came from Negros Occidental. This now brings the number of casualties, Filipino casualties there, to 3, and 3 remain missing. There are about 92 Filipinos in the Gaza Strip who are currently asking for repatriation. This is about 70% of the number of Filipinos there. And this is where it gets tricky. Some of these Filipinos are married to Palestinians. And if humanitarian corridors are indeed open, it's a possibility that only foreigners will be allowed to exit the Gaza Strip. So according to Undersecretary Eduardo De Vega there might be some painful decisions that these families would have to make. Maybe the Filipina mothers will leave with their children, leaving behind their husbands. So that's going to be quite the situation there, and quite the difficulty in processing and deciding what to do once humanitarian corridors are opened up. This is currently what other countries are also working on. The eventual opening up of humanitarian corridors so as to decrease the possibility of civilian casualties as Israel continues to pound the Gaza Strip. Undersecretary Eduardo De Vega also giving the president's detailed instructions to the DFA. He says the president was very clear. The focus should be on Gaza and the repatriation of our Filipinos from there. The president said that what is critical now is Gaza. Let's keep on exploring exit options for Filipino citizens or for our countrymen. That's the president's instructions to the DFA. The president also said that once humanitarian corridors are opened, the DFA must be ready. And this is where Undersecretary De Vega said that they are currently working towards that. But here's the thing. Once the humanitarian corridors are opened, it's not only Filipinos who are going to troop to the borders, other nationalities as well. So they're also preparing for the processing of permits for safe passage, for safe entry into Egypt. And they're also preparing for the eventuality that those who do want to leave Gaza might have to stay long at the border as these papers, these permits are processed for safe entry into Egypt. He also said that as we continue to receive reports about the Israeli blockade in the Gaza Strip, he said that this is not, in so many words, not entirely true, as they have received reports that there is still electricity, water, and food coming in, although limited. So in a way, giving us a glimpse as to how life is for the 130-plus Filipinos who are in Gaza as we speak. There are 131 Filipino citizens in Gaza. Three are tourists. And as I said earlier, 92% or about 70% of this population have already said that they want to come home or to go home.